Broadways, celebrating 60 years of keeping Kenyans healthy. As we celebrate 60 years, we pay tribute to the founders. Our story begins in 1912, when two young men set out on a journey. A journey that took them from Timbri in India to Kenya, with little but inspired visions and hopeful hearts. Fulchand Bai, Maniben, and Veluben soon found themselves in the quiet town of Thika, where they started a general goods business. Under the name of Megji Lakamshi and Brothers, they supplied maize and beans around town in a car. Fulchand Bai's eldest son, Premchand, studied in Nairobi and joined the family business until 1968, when he started a clothing business with his friend, Kimji Bai. In 1958, Broadway's seed was sowed when Ratilal and Sobhagchand ventured into the bakery business to support their family. At the time, bread was a bit of a new concept to the Kenyan palate, but they soon became a hit. The bakery mainly produced bread and scones, which were delivered by bicycle. In 1963, Kenya gained her independence, and with freedom came the drive and passion to build the country. The determination to fuel this motivation increased distribution to Kandara, Katanga, Kitui, and Mwingi. 1964 also saw Dalichand and Chunlilal join the business. Consumption of bread was constantly going up. To cope with the growing demand, we bought distribution rights of Elliott's bread. In the same year, we expanded our distribution to Gatundu and Ruiru. In 1970, Fulchand Bai and his wife Veluben passed away, and the light which had set our dream alight flickered for a moment. In 1972, as part of our expansion plan, we bought Havemore Bakery in Nairobi. In the same year, Premchand migrated to UK with his family. We built new foundations of our own in 1977 when we bought land from the council to set up a new bakery. In 1978, Broadway Premium Bread was born when we installed our first Baker Perkins semi-automatic plant with an investment of $300,000. It had a production capacity of around 70,000 loaves of bread a day. Our distribution expanded to Meru, Embu, Nyeri, and Nanyuki. After registering Broadway Bakery as a limited company in 1978, we registered our trademark in 1979. After the foundation was laid, Amichand and Bimal joined the business. Amichand qualified in pharmacy from UK, while Bimal completed his national diploma in baking with distinction from London. In 1981, we commissioned our second bakery plant, Spooner Plant. With this, our distribution expanded to Nairobi and Machakos. In the same year, there was an intense drought, and it hit the company hard. As a measure to avoid this kind of setbacks, we got a milling license from National Cereal and Produce Board to set up a wheat mill in Thika to safeguard our supply of baker's flour. This gave birth to Bakex Millers. In 1983, Bakex installed a new 150-ton buller mill along with 3,000-ton silo capacity. In 1984, Hiten joined the business after completing his studies in Switzerland and India, qualifying as a milling technologist. In 1985, with an investment of 3 million Deutschmarks, we installed our first W&P bakery plant, which had a production capacity of 100,000 loaves a day. With an enhanced output, we started distributing bread to the Nakuru, Naivasha, and Nyahururu area. This increase in demand saw us put up an extra 5,000-ton storage capacity at Bakex Millers. Having completed his studies in the UK, Bejul joined the business in 1988 and started assisting his father in handling the logistics. In 1992, With an investment of 2.5 million Deutschmarks, we purchased our second W&P bakery plant and increased our total baking capacity to 340,000 loaves a day. In 1995, we started Broadway Steel Limited, manufacturing Safi steel wool and nails, which we ran until 2010. 2000 was a turning point for the company, as this was the year that there was a change of guard. The baton was handed over to Bimal, Hitten, and Beju. With a change in guard started the era of stability and growth. Together, they steered the company to a new promising direction. In 2001, they oversaw the installation of a wax coating and printing plant for our unique packaging, which has always been our company trademark.
I am very glad that this has been an opportunity for me to pay tribute to our founders. From 1979, when I joined together with my uncle Arvind, the bread business started growing, and of course we could see the benefit of me having graduated as a baker from London. So the training I had from my father initially for the first 10 to 12 years was so important to my life. My father would look after the accounts. My uncle Ratilal would look after government policies and everything. My uncle Dalichan would look after the accounts for the distributors, whereas my uncle Chiman was more into logistics and looking after the maintenance of plant and maintenance of the vehicles and everything. As well as Arvin, my uncle, he would look after the distribution and everything like that. For me and Bharti, of course, when I met her, when we got married in 81, she's a Thika girl, and I've known her since I was at the age of 14. So it made things much easier for me. And Bharti has really looked after our three children when I was quite busy in the bakery. But she made sure that she looked after them. And then, of course, Bharti, you can say what you think about it.
We've been married 36 and a half years now. Initially, Bimal really worked hard, and he had less time for the family, but still, we brought our children up well. And I'm so privileged to be part of this family, part of this big enterprise, and I've seen it grow.
As the business grew up to 2000, the brothers felt that they should now hand over the baton to the second generation, which was for me, Hitten, and Beju. Slightly, we were a bit shocked, but we felt that, okay, now, since we have already been put in the deep water, how should we really progress? So the first initial years were full of stability, bringing efficiency. And as soon as 2002, Minal joined us in the financial department, and she quickly turned the whole thing around. But we as a family, we have been able to survive through all the thick and thin. The span of 7 years, we lost 7 family members. But we grew up together, the families were always together, and we tried to help each other. My youngest uncle, Arvind, who of course, after 2000, migrated to London, he has really established very well in London. He has got a few pharmacy shops, a few dental practices, together with his 4 daughters, as well as my uncle, Dalichan. Together with his sons, he started the Capital Industries. Devon and Rohin, when they joined us in 2015, they brought in a more disciplined way of working. In the 70s, we are not used to sitting in board meetings. But now, of course, we have brought in that no discipline to say that now, regularly, once a week, we must all sit together. We must discuss the way we are moving. So the last 5 years, from 2013 to 2018, has seen a lot of progress, a lot of investment, up to about 4 billion Kenya shillings. This is a vision to go into a different level where we are recognized internationally. We want to bring in international partners into our businesses so that we can grow another 5-7 more times in the next 5-10 years. And I want to thank everyone, all our staff, all our directors, all our families, whatever they have done for us and for me in the last few years. I really want to thank them, that without them, it would not have been possible for me to do what I have been doing for the last few years at Broadway.
In 2003, we ventured into real estate. Our first purchase was the UK Centre Mall in Nairobi. Between 2002 to 2012, our workforce increased from 100 to 500. In the same decade, we invested in computerization to achieve accounting efficiency. As part of our CSR initiative, we have greatly contributed to the community, mostly in education, healthcare, and providing employment to people with disabilities, among others. In 2012, our family celebrated 100 years in Thika, which is simply incredible. To get to live what was once a dream, it's not a feeling many people get to enjoy. In 2013, we invested into another real estate project called the Albizia Downs Estate Limited in Thika. In the same year, we replaced the Bakex Miller's 150-ton mill with a new 250-ton Buller mill and installed two 4,000-ton silos. In 2014, we set up our first distribution center in Eldoret. With this, we expanded our reach to Kitale, Kakamega, Kisumu, Kericho, Kisii, Bungoma, other parts of Western Kenya. The memories of those who have been instrumental in shaping our story are still with us today. They use their lives in touching hearts and creating something that will outlast all of us. In 2015, Devon and Rohin joined the company. With fresh blood came fresh ideas. They started more aggressive and intensified marketing and brand building. They started the Sugar Smart campaign, 7-to-7 kiosks, and introduced the Vitaflour brand, among other projects. In 2016, we commenced the construction of a 300-ton Buller mill, which was completed in late 2017.
I would like to express my gratitude to our fathers, with whose vision this year we are celebrating the 60th anniversary of Broadway Bakery. I did my milling technology in Switzerland, and then I went to do a further milling technology in India. I came back in the year 1984 and joined the family business. We started our wheat mill plant in 1983. Initially, the NCPB had given us a quota of 75 tons per day. However, we persevered. My father, Ratilal Okaka, Shobu Kaka, Chiman Kaka, they would always come to the mill day in, day out. And especially Kaka, even after suffering a stroke and he was on a wheelchair, he would make sure that every day he was here at the mill. And because of their guidance and vision, I think that is why we have actually excelled or we have come this far.
Chiman Kaka, hariye hariye kaam karta tha. Ji kaam thindo hi manase koi divas na nothi kai. Shobu kaka eva jata. Kadai no saath bahu hato apan. Ji eva saath re mane lage chhe.
We were the first company to get a license to import wheat. Bejul aggressively went into marketing for the home baking market. So with that aggressive marketing of the brands Oboma and Vitaflour, we found that the existing mill that we had, we could not keep up with the market. So in the year 2013, we put up a 250-ton wheat mill plant. 80% of the big biscuit manufacturers, 80% of their requirement is supplied by us. Slowly we found that because of the improvement in quality, we were not even able to keep up with the market demand. And so we decided to put up another 300-ton mill plant, which we actually commissioned last year. A semolina, which is used in making of pasta, is being imported. We are very proud that as a Kenyan company, we are able to produce and give it to the pasta manufacturers. When I got married, my wife used to complain that I think the meal was more of my home than the house. And I would like to introduce you, Rishna, who is my wife.
I would always argue with him, being a Sunday, why do you need to go to the mill? But you can see today what the importance of going to the business every day of the week. It really pays off, and now I believe in that. I actually believe in that. This only comes with immense hard work. And I'm proud of all our men of our family. We've really looked after the business. They've really looked after us as their wives, their families. And I feel very proud to be in this family.
We as brothers, me, Bejul and Bimal, we want to keep on expanding our business and make it to such a level that we would be among one of the international companies to be recognized.
The following year saw Broadways commission the third W&P plant with a capacity of 100,000 loaves and changed the mixing technology using Diosna mixers. In 2018, we started a Rondo plant making mandazis, donuts, and the now popular KDF. With the great success over the years, we continue to be innovative by introducing our first upcoming bulla at a mill in Kenya and Africa as a whole.
I studied in UK and joined the family business at a very early age. My dad used to teach me so many things. He had a lot of experience in mechanical and maintenance, but a tragic incident happened in 2005. He passed away.
And my husband passed away 13 years before. I feel lonely, very lonely. Lage che. Ji hun pani ene miss karu chu. Ene raat te divas choya vagar aya Broadway ma kaam karyu che. Raat na 3 vage phone aave to jaldi dodi ane mechanic nu kaam gaadi niche suine karyu che. Ene raat divas choya vagar kaam karyu che. And still, badhai ne remember kare che, Beju, Bimal, and Hitu.
My uncles and my cousins, they supported me throughout. Sobhu Kaka used to come at 4 o'clock and have tea with me, and he used to chat with me and discuss the whole day's work. Soon, business started growing. We increased our fleet from 30 to 130. We have a fully maintained workshop. I started coming even at bake eggs, which wasn't at that level. So I started marketing. The old mill was running at full, which we found that now we need to change it and put another mill. So we put another second mill, and now we have a capacity of 600 tons a day, which shows that the business is moving in the right direction. My pillar, my wife, is always with me.
One thing very special about our family, unity, equality, and the effort all the family members make. I count myself to be very lucky to be married in this family, which has got a lot of support.
As Broadway is celebrating 60 years, I am celebrating my 50 years. And I feel now my age is catching me. I hope my younger nephews, Devon, Rohin, will continue the same legacy. And soon Jai, when he finishes, will follow the footsteps of our forefathers, fathers, and will continue keeping Broadway number one.
First bakery to install Baker Perkins plant.
First bakery to install a Spooner plant.
First millers to install metal silos.
The first bakery to install Wonder and Friday bread plant.
First private millers to import a full 30,000 ton vessel of wheat.
First bakery to introduce plastic crates in storage and transportation of bread.
First bakery to start a staff provident and life assurance scheme.
First millers to install a 300 ton mill in a steel structure building.
First millers to import Belgian wheat and flour beans from SCE.
the first bakery to install Duosna mixing systems.
First bakery to install a fully automated rondo plant.
First millers to install a Bueller specialized atta mill.
We are number one!
The journey continues.